and it smiles all around for both these trainers who have made their way down Victory Road to this final stage. James is no stranger to this part of the competition, having won 3 regional championships already in the past, getting top 4 at Worlds a couple of times, and has done a fantastic job of showcasing some of the great new tools in the Teal Mask DLC, in addition to the Goldengo, which really was his signature Pokemon throughout the competition.
Yeah, that Wellspring Ogerpon has been such a force to be reckoned with across all of our trainers in this competition. But Lucatragit, yet another bright VGC star who last season had so much success. 2 top 4s, basically back to back. He got day 2 at Worlds, having to go through that day 1 gauntlet to be able to get there. And he's also going to be bringing an Ogerpon in, that Hearthflame Ogerpon, but also his signature Pokemon, the Black Glasses Defiant King Gambit.
Yeah, he used the Black Glasses Defiant King Gambit at a time in the metagame last year when many people were relying on bulk for that Pokemon. Black Glasses boosts the damage done by Dark-type moves, and spoiler alert, King Gambit loves to use those Dark-type moves to deal damage. So his signature Pokemon not only getting him through to Day 2 of Worlds last year, but also to this final stage here in Peoria.
And what's amazing too is that King Gambit has a much better place in the meta right now, and that's why it's really also just kind of a comfort pick. Not only is it just better, but Luca understands the ins and outs of this Pokemon in particular, and it can play a big role here versus the Goldengo that's on James's side. So how do these Pokemon really match up against each other, and what kind of coverage options exist to be able to keep those two in check? And do James and Luca even bring it? Because think about how James navigated through his top 4 set.
Exactly. We saw James face off against another King Gambit user in top 4. And guess what? The Goldengo was just nowhere to be seen. He did still bring his Intimidate user, that Hisuian Arcanine, which did run the threat of activating the Defiant ability. But interestingly enough, his opponent also left the King Gambit behind. And knowing that he has the Urshifu, knowing that the Ogerpon as well can hit so, so hard, I don't think it's easy for Luca to lock into that King Gambit as we go into this game number 1.
Well, especially because James has access to the Iron Hands. Those Drain Punches have been so powerful, and these Iron Hands just so tanky and not easy to take down. So that King Gambit does not have nearly as comfortable a place right now in this matchup as you might want to have. But what Luca lacks in the King Gambit, he's able to bring back in other forms of offense. That Fluttermane, I'm looking at that Hearthflame Ogerpon, with that Mold Breaker just being so nice to have, and just being able to dish out big damage into basically everything else except that Wellspring if you're not going to hit it with a grass type attack.
Well, it's also interesting that you bring up the Wellspring Ogerpon, because this matchup is also a bit of a capsule of what the metagame has looked like. Hearthflame Ogerpon and Wellspring Ogerpon were 2 of the most popular Ogerpon here this weekend, and now they are 2 of the Pokemon here in the finals as we get started with this game number 1.
Game number 1 of the Peoria Regional Finals between James Beck and Lucatragit is underway. Luca is going to kick things off with the Fluttermane and the Hearthflame Ogerpon. And for James, he has the Urshifu Rapid Strike and the Iron Hands.
Fluttermane is in a great position here to go immediately on the offense, as it does have that Ghost Typing, which means it is not threatened by Fake Out. It's also holding Choice Specs. It is one of the most powerful special attackers in the game right now, and 2 of its most common targets are standing across the field from it right now. The big question here is, will James let this Fluttermane get an attack in, or will he try and make a defensive switch like we've seen him rely on in past games in order to keep one of these 2 Pokemon safe? We've seen that Urshifu like to swap around a lot, but it's actually Luca who's starting things off with a switch, saving that Fluttermane as possibly an end game position for him, setting in the Tornadus in its spot.
Yeah, the Fluttermane looks so good there as well, because you're looking at the Urshifu and the Iron Hands on the other side and saying, okay, Dazzling Gleam looks fantastic here. But if you leave that Pokemon on the field, you run the risk of it getting knocked out immediately, especially when you know that this Urshifu is the Rapid Strike. It's gonna be hitting really hard. And then Ogerpon takes the Fake Out too. So Surging Strikes is open to just hit into this Tornadus. It doesn't look like it's gonna be enough to be able to pick up the knockout, but Tornadus is taking a significant amount of damage. that you just lose the citrus berry now, and you're really forced into a position where this Tornadus has to start getting value up now.
Well, fortunately for Tornadus, the one thing that it loves to do in these Pokemon battles is utilize its Prankster ability to set up Tailwind immediately on the field and then get knocked out. So interestingly enough, James might not attack that Pokemon this turn, anticipating that it's going to set up Tailwind, anticipating that it's going to be a bit more of a passive Pokemon on the field right now, and focus in on that Ogerpon, which is one of the most powerful Pokemon. Hearthflame also with the Mold Breaker ability, the ability to boost its attack if it decides to Terastalize. There are so many things this Ogerpon can do this turn to deal some big damage to the Iron Hands or possibly the Urshifu.
What's really tough in this position, though, is that this Urshifu is also naturally faster. So if you do end up seeing something like the Tailwind come through from Luka's side, that Urshifu is just out of here. So James decides to keep it safe, bring it back into its Pokeball, to bring out his own Tornadus in its place. And there is a Terastalization. This is going over to that Hearthflame Ogerpon. May as well get it up and running, even in the face of something so detrimental like a Rapid Strike Urshifu.
Yeah, that Embody aspect as well, going to boost its attack by one stage, and that could mean the Horn Leech would have been enough to pick up the KO on the Urshifu. There's the Tailwind for that speed support, and here comes that attack.
Tornadus wants to take that even better than that Urshifu would have liked. So, Drain Punch in response. Ogerpon does take a pretty good chunk of damage from that. But now it's time for James to start maybe matching that Tailwind, and it's also staggered. So if James is able to get this up second, he will have a turn or two that he will be able to have the speed more in his favor.
It puts Luka in a tough position because you might want to swap out your Tornadus to try and reset the Tailwind later on in the match, but you don't necessarily want to send Fluttermane out onto the field. It's not a bulky Pokemon. You don't want to risk it taking damage. I think that's exactly why he uses Protect this turn. Just figure out what his opponent's going to do and try to find the opportunity to win the speed control long term.
Yeah, and Horn Leech here as well. It's just gonna help keep this Ogerpon safe. There's not a lot that this Iron Hands can do to threaten a knockout onto this Ogerpon, but I mean, Wild Charge is still a hefty amount. This Horn Leech is only gonna be healing up ever so slightly to mitigate this damage coming in from the Iron Hands. And now that you've also matched speeds, James is in a pretty good position to just kind of either start dealing damage with something like the Bleak Wind Storm or switch out to something that might be even better. You can see him checking those Tailwind turns to see whether or not he's going to be able to actually preserve his Tornadus, or even if Luka may want to preserve his.
I also find it interesting that we've seen Luka primarily rely on Horn Leech here for damage, and I think he's just being extra afraid of the threat of a Rain Dance from the opposing Tornadus, as unless he has his Urshifu in the back of the party, setting up Rain to weaken those Fire-type Ivy Cudgels could be huge.
Ooh. Iron Hands on a little bit of a precarious position after that Horn Leech. This may be enough healing, especially if this Bleak Wind Storm sadly is going to miss the Fluttermane and not the Ogerpon. But you were definitely wanting to play for a miss out with the Heavy Slam read again. How are these trainers able to get this right every single time? A one-hit knockout into the Fluttermane means a major source of damage is now off the field for Luka.
You know, it makes sense to click Heavy Slam there, though, because even if it is still that Tornadus on the field, it's taken so much damage. It's possible that would have been a knockout anyways. You don't risk taking recoil damage from the Wild Charge. And if you do catch a Fluttermane on a switch, it just does so much damage. You can ring that bell, get that knockout, and then move on with this match. As Fluttermane, again, is really one of the most offensive Pokemon we've seen Luka reveal so far in this matchup. Now that it's removed, that makes this battle so much harder for him to win.
Yeah, that was why, like, the turn one, it was already very scary. There's the Urshifu and the Iron Hands on the opposing side. You can hit both of them super effectively, but now the Tornadus comes into play. It's under Tailwind. You fall for the taunt, and now Tornadus, though, not falling for that trick, goes for the Bleak Wind instead, recognizing how these speeds really stack up against each other. So Iron Hands now off the field. This Ogerpon still has the chance to go for some damage and didn't see the Rain Dance. So if this is enough to be able to knock out this Tornadus, now the Tailwind is off the board for James too. down to his final two Pokemon here, which we know is the Urshifu.
It's interesting that James has opted to bring Taunt on his Tornadus versus Luka's own Protect. Certainly he can't use it now as he has been taunted, but Luka with three Pokemon remaining could decide to swap out that Tornadus so that it can reset the Tailwind later on. With the reveal of James's final two Pokemon, though, of that Urshifu Rapid Strike and the Ogerpon Wellspring form, this poor Ogerpon on Luka's side of the field is really going to struggle here, and I think has to hope that it can find an opportunity to get that Horn Leech to connect with the Urshifu somehow, even with the Tailwind still up on both sides of the field.
Yeah, I mean, HP recovery would be great, but we do see the Tornadus at least get rid of the Taunt here in hopes that the Urshifu will not get knocked out in this turn. It is a Follow Me as well, so Luka's just content for this Ogerpon to go down here as it's gonna fall to the Earth Surging Strikes coming through from James. Even only takes one hit for that knockout to go through. Does mean that the Tornadus can come back in for free. That Taunt has now been refreshed, so Tailwind is definitely a possibility here.
It is, and I think what the other possibility here as well, as we see this Ivy Cudgel do a little bit of damage to that Urshifu, is we see James's Tailwind expire, and this is the perfect timing for Luka's own Tornadus to take the field. Now, looking at Luka's Urshifu, as I don't think we've seen this Pokemon yet in this set, it is not running the Choice Scarf like James's own Urshifu. It's running Focus Sash, so that Sash has been broken, but it can choose to change its moves, and Close Combat is definitely the bigger damage onto the Ogerpon.
Oh, but that Ogerpon is just so tanky. That Close Combat wasn't enough. And so we see the Surging Strikes able to connect in the Tornadus, and it was on such low HP already that this is going to be an easy way to clean it up. But we still have yet to also see this Ogerpon move, and Luka's Urshifu is just a sitting duck in this position. James has been able to weave in a fantastic endgame for this game number one, so James is gonna be up 1-0 in this finals.
Power Whip sealing the final damage against that Urshifu, another unique adaptation from James's Ogerpon in particular. We've seen most of the Ogerpon here this weekend run Ivy Cudgel, as it is one of the best new moves released in the DLC, alongside of Spiky Shield, maybe a Follow Me, maybe a Horn Leech, but Power Whip is high risk, high reward. It does more damage, and it's one of the most powerful physical grass type moves out there, but it can miss. But you don't need to worry about missing a one-hit knockout when you target down Heavy Slam into that Fluttermane that swapped in. Again, that was such an incredible read from James, and the fact that we've seen that exact turn play out twice throughout this tournament is really exciting.
Well, you made a great call though, right? Heavy Slam was just a perfect option in that particular instance because it covers for the knockout onto the Tornadus, and then if you catch the Fluttermane, wow, are you in a good spot for the rest of the game. So James just so heavily able to swing that momentum in his favor. And it's not like Luka has a terribly bad matchup with this either. That Hearthflame Ogerpon is a little bit more difficult to be able to put into the right position to deal with the Wellspring Ogerpon as well as the Urshifu on James's side, but he was still confident enough in that pick to be able to bring it.
I also find it very interesting that James's two Pokemon in the back towards that end game were his two water type Pokemon, recognizing that the Hearthflame Ogerpon was kind of stuck out on the field. You know, it felt like Luka couldn't really swap that Pokemon around as much as he would have liked, largely due to how the Fluttermane was KO'd so quickly, and I think also largely due to the fact that he didn't have his bulkier Pokemon available to him. You know, looking at his overall team composition, you know, the Landorus would love to be able to U-turn in and out of the field to get those Intimidates. The King Gambit as well tends to be a little bit more naturally bulky compared to the other Pokemon on his team. But with neither of those Pokemon available to Luka at that point in time, I think it was very safe for James to keep those water Pokemon in the back and then just have them clean up once the threat of Ogerpon had been dealt with.
I do wonder if that final turn looks a little bit differently if Luka does go for something like the Spiky Shield instead. If you are anticipating the Urshifu trying to target that down, then maybe you just get a couple of extra chip damage in there, and something like an Aqua Jet might be able to just kind of pick it up or just some sort of extra damage from your faster Pokemon now that Tailwind is active.
Yeah, there were certainly options for him in that end game, and it's so tough to call indeed. I think that you really, at that point in time, you're playing James's own game, and that can be very intimidating. I mean, James is one of the most decorated Pokemon players who competed here this weekend, and, you know, staring him down in the finals with the pressure on you, not only just for this one particular match, but really the whole tournament has built up to this moment. I think it's very easy to sort of lose track of those more minute win conditions, those little bits of chip damage that you need in order to lock in those knockouts for your other Pokemon. But you do have time here to reset in between games, and you do have a moment to breathe, to meditate, like we were just saying before the break. And really, you need to take every single opportunity to ground yourself, as, you know, game two is a fresh start. You didn't win game number one, but you can certainly come back game number two and then win game number three to still win that championship title.
Absolutely. And so, you know, both trainers are going to be thinking very critically about these next leads. Do we see the run back? Is James confident enough in that strategy? He did decide to leave the Golden Go at home, which is something that we saw him do in that top four set. There's so many different threats. And also just Arcanine just not feeling quite good into this either. Just in case Luca, for some reason, decides to bring that King Gambit, things could get very out of hand very quickly if the right pieces of your puzzle aren't in front of that King Gambit to take it out. But it looks like we are about ready to get into this game number two of the finals of the Peoria Regional Championships. James Beck is up 1-0 over Luca Traget, but Luca needs to win this next game to get back into things. Let's go ahead and get into game.
Well, if there's one way to start the game off on the right foot, it is with the Ogre Pond and the Tornadus on Luca's side of the field. James opting for the same lead that we saw from him in game number one. And unlike James's own Tornadus, unfortunately, Luca's is not holding that covert cloak. So that means that a fake out is a real threat for him right now. And if he's really worried about that, you could go for a protect, but then maybe James tries to take advantage of that. Leading the Iron Hands is such a great position for him to be in this matchup because it's so bulky. It gives you the opportunity to flinch, and it gives you the option to do significant damage to both those Pokemon on Luca's side as well.
But this is a much better position for Luca to be in. You saw that the Fluttermane was a lead for Luca in that game number one, but this time around, not showing that in hand just yet. James is going to be the first to make a pivot. It's going to be his own Tornadus now hitting the field to match that of Luca's, and the Protect makes so much sense in case you were worried about the fake out, like you were saying. But now Ogre Pond is just able to go for the Horn Leech. Would have been a nice target if that was still the Urshifu, but at the very least, this Tornadus gets protected from this Wild Charge. So a really good turn here for both trainers.
And now we get a really interesting interaction here because we have not seen both of these Tornadus have the opportunity to move on the field at the same time. Luca could still opt to swap out that Tornadus like we saw him do in game number one, but we saw how poorly that went for him previously. I don't think that's a risk you take the second time around. I think you might just try and go for a Tailwind or try to go for a Bleak Windstorm, get that slight speed advantage, and then utilize Ivy Cudgel to deal Fire-type damage to knock out the opposing Tornadus before they set up Tailwind. It's this big game right now of will they, won't they Tailwind, and giving yourself an extra boost of Terastalization damage is gonna help you power through, but that is not an Ogre Pond.
It's not an Ogre Pond. That is in fact a Tornadus, and you are seeing things correctly, that is the Poison Terror type for this Tornadus, and it's a Rain Dance, expecting some Fire-type damage to come through here from that Ogre Pond and maybe being able to mitigate that. But on the flip side of things, that Rain Dance sets up this Bleak Wind Storm perfectly. Now this is going to be fully accurate in the rain, and the Ivy Cudgel, yes, its damage does get mitigated, but Tornadus is still gonna be able to hang on. Look at that Heavy Slam as well. What a fantastic poison defensive terror type to really help keep this Tornadus alive.
And not only that, opting to go straight for the Bleak Wind Storm on his Tornadus on the off chance that James went for the taunt into that Pokemon. Had they both gone for Prankster boosted attacks, you could enter this interesting speed tie where if James's Tornadus went first and went for a taunt, then Luka's own Tornadus would not have been able to move there. You know, we haven't seen these speed tiers play out yet. One has always been using Prankster versus the other one doing damage, but maybe this is finally the indication of how that'll play out.
Nope, you're not gonna get that this time around either, Gabby. Sorry, because it is the Tailwind and Luka's going to continue to commit to the Bleakwind Storm. The Horn Leech too, just dealing some chip. This Iron Hands does have a bit of a predicament where it's not easy to be able to get that HP recovery right now. So you may as well try to get that damage down, and Tornadus very easily be able to reserve some of this HP through the Citrus Berry.
An excellent use of Terastalization. That defensive Terra that you called out allowed that Tornadus to hold on for that plus one turn, so that if Luka goes for Tailwind here, they are staggered once again, but this time he will benefit from that additional turn of Tailwind. That being said though, we could see a really interesting interaction play out here, as Urshifu also has access to a priority move and is speed boosted by Tailwind right now.
Yeah, but the biggest issue too is that, you know, even though you're able to get the Bleakwind down, it is gonna be more accurate in the rain. It knocked out the Tornadus just to allow this water type Urshifu to be able to hit the field. Terastalization is committed. All of these surging strikes are gonna be even more powerful, and Tailwind now getting matched by Luka. Now he gets a chance to stagger that out, but is he going to be able to last that long? Surging strikes are now in full effect here for James, and that Urshifu on the income not going to be taking as much damage, but that's still a significant amount, and we still have yet to see what the Iron Hands is going to do.
Yeah, if James called this switch and attacked that Urshifu, that could be a critical one turn knockout there, knocking out one of Luka's most powerful Pokemon right when it hit the field.
And that was great coverage as well. Either you get the knockout onto the Hearthflame Ogre Pond with the Surging Strikes, and if you double into that slot, then you're able to just hit something else. What a great call by James. He's just playing so fundamentally, and this matchup has just felt like his game the entire time. He is so close to getting another regional championship under his belt, but Luka is giving it everything he's got. He still has the Hearthflame Ogre Pond, but he also still has a fourth and final in the back.
And you also have to remember that he will have one turn of Tailwind where there isn't a Tailwind set up on James's side of the field. For now though, the speeds are tied with the callouts of that Choice Scarf on the Urshifu. So James can pretty comfortably target into the Choice Specs Fluttermane on Luka's side of the field. He has to make a tough call here. Do you try and swap in that Ogre Pond to take damage and stall out this turn so Fluttermane can take the advantage, or do you just hope that somehow there's a way?
Well, at least the Tailwinds are matched here, so that does help out a little bit to not have to deal with the Iron Hands as much, but you're right, this Fluttermane is just under so much pressure that Luka doesn't have an option right now except to remove it from the field, bring the Ogre Pond back in, and just hope that it's enough. But it's the Surging Strikes to move first, and it is going right into that Ogre Pond with the Rain Boost, the Terra, the same type attack bonus. Ogre Pond does not stand a chance. And this Iron Hands also gets a chance to follow up if it doesn't get knocked out first by this Tornadus.
It's going to be tough, as even though Bleakwind Storm is going to connect with both these Pokemon,
it's just
it doesn't do enough damage. The Assault Vest Iron Hand taking another hit to fire back. A Wild Charge will be knocked out by the recoil damage, but it has done its job. Luka only has one Pokemon left, keeping James from that fourth regional champion title.
Iron Hands does go down, but the Fluttermane, you can see Luka shaking his head. He does not believe that this Fluttermane is going to be enough, because what's in the back? It's that Wellspring Ogre Pond that has yet to have hit the field. It's in the rain. It's just set up for success. And while the fact that this Fluttermane does have those choice specs, James still has the ability to hit it really hard. Dazzling Gleam comes out first. Now the speed's in his favor. The Urshifu does go down here, but the Wellspring Ogre Pond gets a chance to fight back. One more Pokemon stands in between James's way. The rain, the Ivy Cudgel, Fluttermane goes down, and James Beck is your Peoria Regional Champion,
showcasing the signature Pokemon of the Golden Go throughout Swiss. It was the Ogerpon that delivered that final bonk to victory for James, and what an incredible victory it was indeed.